Okay, gentlemen, today is meatball day. I still have a ton of this Nilgai left, so I'm going to make some meatballs. I'm just going to show you how I do my meatballs. After I make the meatballs, I'm going to simmer them in Volpino vodka sauce from Billme8, and I'm also going to make some brown gravy. I'm going to split the batch, so to speak, and I'm going to put half and half and then simmer them for about an hour. It makes them nice and tender. And for ingredients today, we have two green onions, we have garlic, we have Worcestershire sauce, aka Winchester sauce, some breadcrumbs, some Montreal steak seasoning, one egg, and Nilgai. 2 pounds of Nilgai. I almost forgot. Gotta have some bacon grease. Now this is the best part. This is the part I love. I get to chop up all the vegetables and everything and mix everything up, and I put some funky music on there and speed up the film. Looks real cool.
I am the one that controls the blade. You best go with the flow, for resistance is futile. It merely sharpens the blade.
Mix the hell out of it. Time to make the meatballs. Make them a little bit big, make them a little small. Whatever you like. I like them kind of bite-sized. And they're just perfect. You can get like 50 of them on your plate, too. Now what you want to do is just brown all these meatballs. Of course I got a whole bunch more. But just push them around in the pan, brown them, and then we're going to drop them off in the sauce. Okay, this is how I make the brown gravy. This is my mix. Some cool water. Want to add some flour. Whole mess of pepper. And soy sauce. Now you can add any type of soy sauce, it really doesn't matter. You know, if you got your favorite one, go for it, you know. I'm going to add two different types because I'm trying to get rid of this. The rest of this jar here, because it's taking up all the room in my pantry. This is real good stuff. It's Maggie sauce, but it's just another soy sauce. And mix the hell out of it. Oh, those are looking good, and man, the smell, you wouldn't believe. Now we're going to simmer those meatballs in that Volpino vodka sauce from Billme8. Next load is up! A meatball! Okay, y'all, you've seen this skillet before, but I'm going to give you the history on it. If you notice, right there, those are brass rivets. Now check this out. See that? That is a patch. It's a piece of brass with brass rivets holding on that corner of this pan. Now, I was about 10 years old. That chipped off on my father, and he didn't like throwing good stuff away, so He took the little piece of cast iron, drilled holes in it, and put a brass patch on it. And so that's why this pan is sitting on my stove today. Now, I was about 10 years old, so this pan's probably 40, 50, 60 years old. I have no clue. And as you can tell, it's smooth, slick with seasoning. And it's one of my favorite pans because it gives you room to move. And of course, those Nilgai meatballs look awful good in there. Now here's the deal, you never want to let good grease go to waste. So let's make some gravy. Now we're going to bring that up to a simmer. Mmm! Damn, that's good. Now the best part of being the cook is you get a free sample. Perfect. I mean, perfect. That's a perfect meatball. Oh man, that's good. Now the next thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cook some pasta, because this stuff has to go on something, right? Okay, y'all, here's the deal. Check this out. See that? That's that sauce that Billme8 sent me. That's good. I mean, that's real good. It's got a marinara taste to it, and then it's got some heat. It's got some heat. That's good. Need to get some. And if you don't, not my problem, but this stuff is really good. Really good. I can't quit eating these damn things. Oh, the sauce is good. I'm gonna show you another view of this skillet. See that patch? That's some serious dedication right there. And if you look at the bottom of this, smooth, slick. That's why I cook in cast iron, because it lasts forever, and it's the best stuff made. Just don't buy any Chinese crap. Got to be real careful these days. A lot of these celebrity chefs are pushing some Chinese crap. And if you can tell, really not liking Chinese manufacturing in present. But this is good old American steel. I don't know what the manufacturer is. I'm going to assume it's Griswold, Wagner, Erie maybe, something like that. Or it might be a lodge, but there's no name on it. But they did that a lot, so that's it. Check that out. Okay, let me show you. That's some meatballs and brown gravy. That's the Volpino vodka sauce from Billme8. That's some zucchinis. Going to combine that tonight. That's my dinner for this evening. And this is for the sampling right now. And we're going to add a little cheese to that too, right here. Nothing like a little Parmesan. Yeah, I know, you guys got to watch me eat again. Got a couple of zucchinis, half a meatball. That's fantastic. That is fantastic. I'm telling you, if I went to like a fine Italian restaurant and I had this, you know, you'd be down there kissing the boots of the chef. Of course, none of y'all come to my house and start kissing my boots. That just ain't working, you know. I like my white boots. I don't want your lipstick all over them, okay? But this stuff is excellent, and that's how I make my meatballs, and I got to get my butt to work. So that's it, guys. Appreciate you watching. Ha 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 ha!